This is NDTV. And you're watching NDTV Prime.
Moving on to better things, it's a total knockout, your trailer of Mukkabaaz, all set to pack a punch. Aapne waise kaafi punches diye hue hain.
Nahi, I'm very happy. I really want to put this film out there and I want to see how people respond and react to it.
And also you said this is like your first love story.
It is my first love story. And it's purely a love story, which also is a love story of a sportsman. It's about dreams and aspirations and love.
Yeah, and also we don't see too many sports films. We have, but they're on these heroes. We celebrate the heroes, never the underdog.
We don't celebrate the sport also. We don't celebrate the sport, we don't celebrate the sportsman. We celebrate heroes, yeah, but we are a country of hero worship. So that you can't take away. We have always been a country of hero worship. We have always been a country that totally head to toe believes in nepotism.
You've said it, nepotism was the most abused term last year in the industry. But then there are people like
No, it's in daily life. Nepotism is there in daily life, on an everyday life. It's like at home, you people marry family, you don't marry a person. You know, whose family se belong karta hai, aisa hai. Wo nepotism hi to hai aur kya hai? Matlab, doctor ka beta doctor banta hai, engineer ka beta engineer banta hai. Aapka father ka business aap inherit karte ho. Wo bhi to nepotism hai, no?
And do you think there's no nepotism in the industry? We are very secular and...
Everyone is nepotistic. Everyone. I am nepotistic. Vineet has access to me because I know Vineet, I've worked with him. I cast Azoya Hussain in the film. I've known her for 4 years. I've known her as an actor for 2 years.
Yeah.
I've seen her work. My confidence and sense of security also comes from familiarity.
Absolutely. Right? But that's human nature also.
That's human nature. So I'm also nepotistic that way. So who am I to accuse anybody else?
And also when you said, it was very interesting, you said you went to the CBFC, they gave a US certificate because you were, they asked you what was your motive behind the film.
They saw the film in context, you know, because there's a lot of controversies on the basis of assumption. And people picked out a line from the trailer, "Hum Brahman hai adesh dete hai," and they started to brew something, accusing me of trying to divide society on the basis of caste, bringing casteism after with the film and all that. People start assuming things. You know, every time you see, there's a controversy blows up before the film.
Yeah.
Right? And if the film comes out, there's nothing that happens after that. Everything is based on assumption. Everything is based on assumption.
True.
That's what has been going on. So, us line ko leke, and now, it's like a very simple thing. You know, they don't know the film. No, the film is, there's a character who's an antagonist. Who prides himself in being a Brahman. There's also other characters who are Brahmins in the film.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And my whole thing is like, and this character has been equated with Raman. Raman was a Brahman. And there's also Sudama who's a Brahman.
True.
So in the trailer, you see the Raman, but you don't see the Sudama, and you start assuming the whole film on the basis of that.
Absolutely.
The film is not talking about, a casteism that's rampant in us. The driving force of the film is not casteism. And the film is not about only about casteism, it's also about reverse casteism. It's also talk about somebody who has been oppressed, has been empowered, who's up there, also thinks that it's his responsibility to get back to the other caste guy who had oppressed him. And it's all based in his mind, as his assumption. I'm saying we all creating things out of assumption. So seeing things in context, when they see the film, there's nothing like that there.
And now like the CBFC also had an advisory committee advising them.
See, I will, because my experience, I went into CBFC with all kind of inhibitions and fears and doubts, and all of it was founded untrue. The way it conducted itself in my film, knowing the kind of accusations that were being thrown up on social network and things, was exemplary. And I would stand by that. I'm the one who's had longest battles with CBFC. I have literally criticized every time. When there's something good they've done, I will stand by it. I am not in Bhansali's place. I don't know what is at stake and what is he's going through. Neither am I in Prasoon's place. And I can say for sure, Prasoon's job is not an easy job. We are also living in a country where everybody, I'm saying he's not, like Pehla Ji was power drunk. And I know that because when he showed us, this is your show cause, but I won't give you in the drawer. We had no other option but to fight back.
Absolutely.
Yeah, there's a reasonable context being given, space being given, and everything. So I don't know, when things have gone out of hand, what kind of political pressures it puts and things like that, I don't know. When I made Bombay Velvet, there's so much at stake. So much at stake. That's my most censored film. I was powerless in front of censor board because the cost associated with the film was so much.
Absolutely.
I became very powerless. And I always believe that people need to stand up for themselves and fight. A constitution that gives other people's rights to protest against you and block you also has given you enough space and your rights to fight it and come out of it. I have not had a single film barring Bombay Velvet that has been cut down by the censor board. The fights could have been longer, but eventually they have all come out intact. So I believe that there is space to fight back. People need to stand up for themselves first.
No, and also like Bhansali is being quiet, nobody is hearing what he's saying.
That's why we don't know what's at stake. My thing is I'm not going to sit here and judge him. I don't know what's at stake for him.
And also they say the industry doesn't stand up. You had a lot of support with Urta Punjab.
Yeah, because I stood up, so everybody will stand up. It's not like that. There's so much else that goes on. It's not always what looks to the eye.
Why is the industry so divided?
Industry is not divided. Industry is not divided. Industry will stand up. If somebody stands up, industry will stand up.
Are there somewhere also very scared?
I was actually a pariah more in the industry that comes from film families than a Bhansali's or anybody else's.
True.
When they can stand up with me, besides me, I don't believe industry is divided. I genuinely believe that every fight, everything is individual. We should not look at it as a collective. Everything can't be bunched up together. Each thing has its own special circumstances and conditions. And they have their own ways of dealing with it. One has to want to deal with it. One has to want to fight back. And we never know what's at stake.
And as a filmmaker, after seeing Padmavati, I mean, will you be like wary of making a historical period film?
I'm saying I was already wary. I'm already wary of making a historical. I'm already wary of making a historical. In my experience, there was a time I was actually wanted to make a film in Rajasthan on Ruti Rani. And when we started researching Ruti Rani, the 10 royals that I met had different versions of the same story. And each one of claimed to be as the Vanchaj, right? And they don't accept each other as Vanchaj. They don't even know of each other. And they all call themselves the Vanchaj and it's my story. I'll tell you what Ruti Rani's story is. So history has been told word of mouth, generation to generation. There's so many contradictory versions of Ruti Rani. I was like, okay, well, I don't know. The only common thing was why she got her name Ruti Rani. Other than that, nothing was common. So I'm saying, which version of history do I feel is right? And when I was researching that, this all blew up. And I was like, I'm sorry. They can't... And I'm a Rajput. I made Gulal exactly on the same thing.
Absolutely.
And Rajputs themselves are not united in any one version of history or what they want or their own communities, nothing. And that's exactly what I was trying to say through Gulal. And it's still the same.
And also as a filmmaker, somewhere you're wary when you see censorship and creative freedom being questioned. Are you wary in these times?
No, it's not that. You know what? When I was making Mukkabaaz, I would look at Iranian filmmakers. A regime that's so much more strict, China. And people are making films there.
True.
And they say what they are bothered by and they say what they feel. They find a way to say it. I'm saying it doesn't mean that I will come and tell you on your face, you're ugly. I will show what can be more beautiful. There's ways of doing things. The thing is, it depends entirely on the intention and the process of a person.
So was making Mukkabaaz like liberating for you after all those heavy
films? No, I learned a lot of new things. I learned so much about sports and what's wrong with sports.
There's also that other aspect, I think.
And also I realized that I can actually do things without being like so in your face.
And I think sports is important because it disciplines one also and helps the mind. And also the other thing, we saw Hollywood stand united with the Harvey Weinstein case. Like everyone wore black. Do you think...
We have a long way to go.
And it happens and we don't talk about it.
No, we have a very long way to go. We need to first, you know... वहाँ तक पहुँचने के पहले हमें पहले तो एजुकेट होना जरूरी है. We are not educated. I'm saying going to school and college doesn't mean we are educated. We don't know our rights. We don't know how it can be. We don't have options. We don't know what possibilities are there, which is very limited, very few people in the cities who are actually, a lot of people who have that kind of a privilege or the knowledge of self and things. But you're talking about a largely 90% population that's still not educated. Whole lot. My data might be totally incorrect. We need to start there first. People need to know their rights. People don't know what their rights are in this country. People really don't know what their rights are. People submit to exploitation knowingly and willingly. We are conditioned by the mindset that wo babu hai, ye chaprasi hai. We have a lot of divides. We don't have just caste and gender divides. We have status divides. And we believe in our positions and we fully become subservient to somebody over us.
True.
We don't understand that a man working on the road has an equal right with a man looking down at him from the building up there.
True, absolutely.
So, we have to reach there for a time. People are scared. People are scared of their judgment. How will someone see us? How will someone say something?
Which is actually very true, that fear factor needs to be
there. And the fear factor is not just about that you know, I'll be picked up or picked out in the crowd or nothing like that. People really fear for themselves, their lives. People don't know how much power anyone wields and what can happen to anyone. It's easier to bring down the powerful in this country than for somebody to stand up.